There are two ways to cut crown. Flat. Vertical is flat, horizontal is flat. You can hold it and cut your angle like that. We'll do that first. Then you measure from your short point to the end. If you're doing a lot of inside miters instead of coping, I prefer this way. And you use the triangles on your saw. Put this down to 33.9 degrees, then 31.6 degrees. And that's the same thing. It's faster for inside miters if you do it this way, in my opinion. And it's more consistent. If you're coping, if you're going for production, the other way works better. This way is more consistent. Now, there are two ways to cope as well. I prefer on the front cut. I like it cutting this way. Some people like it on the pole. I like it on the front cut. Either way, you need to back cut the crown. That is the key to all of this. So, now, this is my front, my back. See how much is out of the back?
That's it.
Another important thing is to mark first so you know where you're going. Push the bottom flat. Make a line. Especially in the corners. You have an idea of where your piece is going to go. Another trick to this is you don't do the last 18 inches to 2 feet so you can adjust your corners if you need to. This can still move up and down to make your miter tighter. Tighter miter. Right. If it needs to go up, you can push it up. See how the top is open currently. Do this ceiling, so I cannot account for the piece that's right there. That is my old man that did that, but the miter looks fucking good.